theologians and other clerks, you won't understand this book. However bright your wits, if you do not meet it humbly, and in this way, love and faith make you surmount reason, for they are the protectors of reason's house. Reason, you'll always be half blind. Love and faith have no shame, no honor, no fear for what is to come. They are secure, says love. Their doors are open. No one can harm them. Now listen, reason, says love, so as to understand better. A person who is on fire feels no cold. A person who is drowning knows no thirst. Now this soul, says love, is so burned in love's fiery furnace that she has become the very fire, so that she feels no fire, for in herself she is fire. Through the power of love, which has changed her into the fire of love, this fire burns of and through itself, everywhere, incessantly, without consuming any matter or being able to wish to consume it, except only from itself. For whoever feels some perception of God through matter, they see or hear outside themselves, or through some labor which they there perform of themselves, is not all fire. Rather, there is some matter together with the fire. For people's labors and their wanting matter outside themselves to make God's love grow in them is only a blinding of the knowledge of God's goodness. But one who burns with this fire, without seeking such matter, without having it, or wanting to have it, sees all things so clearly that they value them as they must be valued. For such a soul has no matter in her which prevents her from seeing clearly, so that she is alone in it through the power of true humility. And she is common to all through the generosity of perfect charity, and alone in God, since perfect love has taken possession of her. This soul, says love, is flayed by mortification and burned by the ardor of the fire of charity, and her ashes are strewn by the nothingness of her will upon the high seas. In prosperity, she has the nobility of the well-born. In adversity, the nobility of one exalted. In all places, whatever they be, the nobility of the excellent. She who is such no longer seeks God through penance or through any sacrament of Holy Church. Not through reflections or words, or works. Not through any creature here below, or through any creature there above. Not through justice, or mercy, or the glory of glories. Not through divine knowledge, or divine love, or divine praise. Love says, meditation of pure love has only one intention, that she might always love faithfully, without wishing for any reward. And the soul cannot do this unless she is deprived of herself. For faithful love would not deign to have any consolation which came by the soul's seeking. Truly not. Meditation of love knows well that it is for the best that she must not exert herself except in what is her task, and that is to will perfectly the will of God. And she leaves God to work and to order God's will as God pleases. For whoever wills that God might fulfill wishes to experience their own comforts does not place their trust solely in God's goodness, but trusts rather in those. And who are you, love? Asks reason. Are you not also one of the virtues and one of us, even though you be above us? I am God, says love, for love is God, and God is love. And this soul is God through its condition of love. And I am God through my divine nature. And this soul is God by love's just law, so that this my precious beloved is taught and guided by me, without herself. For she has been changed into me, and this is the outcome, says love, of being nourished by me. Ah, lady soul, says reason, you have two laws, your own and ours. Ours for belief and yours for love. And therefore you say to us what you please. And so you have called those who we nurture fools and asses. Those whom I call asses, says this soul, seek God in creatures, through worshipping in churches, in paradises they create, in the words of men and in their writings. It seems to beginners that men such as these, who seek God in this way, uphill and down dale, think that God is subject to his sacraments and to his works. Alas, they suffer such trials that it is pitiful, and they will go on suffering them, says the soul, so long as they maintain this way of life and such practices.